Got some sunlight up in here. Got some water, bitch. Hi, everybody. My name is Resley. This first video is going to be about me and my androgynous life. So, what is androgyny? Androgyny is characterized by having the appearance of both female and male. So I think that, I mean, honestly, you can kind of have your own definition of it in general. That's kind of how I look at it. You know, that's not the truth. That's not absolute. But that's just kind of how I look at it, because not everybody feels the same. Everybody's different and everybody has a different mindset. And how my mindset is that on what my androgyny entails is that sometimes one day I want to look a little bit more masculine. You know, maybe one day, you know, I want to put on some heels, bitch. Maybe I want to feel myself, bitch. Like, you know, maybe I just want to, you know, feel fierce and feel, you know, like a femme fatale, bitch. You know, maybe sometimes that's what I want to do. And in other days, maybe I don't want to do that. Maybe I want to be a little bit more masculine today. And I'm entitled to that because I am in control of my life. You know, I am responsible for me. You know, no, I have my own freedom and I take that. I take my own freedom with my androgyny. And that's why my identity is so important to me, you know. But, you know, like, you know, some people may not feel that way. Maybe some people don't feel empowered to be able to, you know, be able to express themselves that way. And that's okay too. You know, but some people like don't really understand it. You know, they interpret it different ways. And I think that that's why these type of videos are so important, so we can spread a message and so we can, you know, really just like get clarity out there for people, so they don't kind of run around like causing a whole bunch of storm and hot mess going on. And so that's where I come in, you know, for clarity. I'm a clarity giver, whatever. Does androgyny affect my relationships? Yes, by all means, androgyny definitely, by all means, affect my relationships in every aspect. In regards to my romantic relationships, bitch. Like, that is an entirely different anecdotal in itself. Like, the gay community, they're like bullies, like a lot of them, not all of them. And, you know, I hate generalization, to be clear. Like, I'm not generalizing everybody in the same bucket. You know, I hate when people do that to me. I'm not going to do that to anybody else. And I try to treat people the way that I want to be treated. So, but in general, like, I'm so certain. I am so certain that there are so many gays that will completely agree with me when I say that people are, gay men are so cruel. Like, they can be so cruel, you know, as far as, you know, being able to, you know, as far as femininity, as far as body shaming, as far as the transgender community, they are so fucking cruel. I don't know. I keep looking at myself. Like, I know I'm supposed to look at the camera, but, you know, like, sometimes you just feel yourself and you feeling cute or whatever, you know, and anyway, so kindness costs nothing. Costs nothing. Like, be kind to people. Like, seriously, be kind to people. It costs nothing, you know, and I don't know. Like, it's just really unfortunate, you know, but it, by all means, it does affect my relationships. And, but honey, you just keep on moving. You keep on pushing. Don't care about these people, what they got to say about you, girl. You do you. You be who you are. You do what the hell you want to do. You know, you live life on the edge as far as, and let me explain, because, you know, some people are like, what? Razzley said, let's live life on the edge. Let me go jump off a building. No, bitch. When I say live life on the edge, dare to be who you are. You know, dare to challenge what the norm is. Dare to go out and live your life to the fullest. And that's, you know, pretty much what I mean by that type of concept. So, a broken nail. So, like, don't look at my nail. Like, my thumbnail, like, it's atrocious right now. But anyway, when it comes to being non-binary, I think when I had this epiphany is when I was younger and they were just like, I'll hang out with some friends that are more on the masculine side and I'll have them say, like, you know, oh, what up, bro? Guys go in, they try to give you, like, the little nuck if your butt going on, like, and I'm just like, first of all,
bitch, don't touch me.
Second of all, I'm not your bro. If you want, call me by my name. I do prefer the pronouns him. It's what I personally prefer, but don't bro me. And on the other, you know, level of it, sometimes I'll have women, they'll come up to me like, hey girl, and I'm like, hey, I don't know you. Why are you talking to me? Why are you hey girling me? I went to the store maybe like a month ago to go shopping for some clothes. So I go in line and I get, I'm ready to check out. You know, I picked out my clothes. I'm like, okay, girl, we looking fierce. You know, this is all I'm going to do. Beauty on the budget up in here. So I ain't going to be spending too much money up in here and get broke and just whatever. That would be a whole fiasco in itself. But I get in the checkout line. I end up just waiting for, like, I don't know. It was like, the line wasn't even that long, but the cashier was taking, like, freaking forever today just to, like, be able to ring the three people up that she did have in line. And she finally gets to me, like, after, like, 25 minutes. She's just like,
ma'am, sir, whatever you are, I'm ready for you.
So, in that instance, what I wanted to say,
bitch, who are you talking to?
Because I know you a bitch. I will bop your ass, bitch. Who are you talking to? There's a certain way to do things, and there's a certain way not to do things. In this case, this was the way that you should not do things. So in that specific case, bitch, you better be lucky you didn't get bopped. Because, you know, I'm, during these days, I'm trying to retire my ratchet. We should, like, make that into a hashtag. Hashtag retire the ratchet. Anyway, I'm trying to retire the ratchet. I'm not trying to be all, you know, like, you know, quick, too impulsive to, like, jump into a situation and, you know, get myself in trouble and whatnot. So I consider myself somewhat of a pacifist, you know. I think that violence isn't the answer. Like, not at all. Like, I think there's always an alternative route to, you know, a way to de-escalate situations. So, you know, but don't, bitch, that don't mean I want to curse, you know, curse somebody out, you know, and bop a bitch, because trust me, I do, girl. And comment, share, tell me how you feel, let me know how you think the structure is, just anything constructive so I can be able to get better in this whole vlogging thing, because this is my first video and I'm breaking my video cherry. Oh my god, like, this is so weird. Anyway, thank you guys so much for, you know, all the people that did support me. I really do appreciate that. Just continue to view. I'll have more stuff coming out, you know, if I am able to start to build a platform for myself. So yeah, that's it. Stay classy.